Welcome back to this Diwali special of Smart Money. Surya Bhatia in Delhi, Suresh Sadgopan in Mumbai, and Lovaii and Navlakhi in Bangalore are still with me. Let me now pose the crucial question to all three of you, which is, why is it that we Indians don't invest as much in equity? Our experience, you will agree, tells us that it's either because it's perceived as too risky, and maybe that's because we go the wrong way. We think markets and equities is about punting. We go out there on the basis of tips. We go and buy and sell shares, lose money, and then we walk away from the market and think it's a gambling den. How important is being in equities to building wealth? Are the two synonymous? If you want to build real wealth, do you have to be in equities? And how much should you be? Surya, let me go with you first.
See, how do you create wealth? Let's go a step back to understand what you really mean by wealth over here. I need to earn income to create wealth, whatever asset class it may be. So basically, I need to first cover my inflation rate to be at par to my money value in real terms. Over and above that, I need to earn to ensure that my value of my saving grows over a long period of time. Yes, equity as an asset class does help me to achieve that. But anything which gives me a return beyond an inflation-adjusted return will carry an element of risk, whatever asset class it may be. The risk may be low or high, but the risk is definitely there. So we need to ensure, how do we mitigate that? Equity as an asset class will help me in mitigating that risk, provided I have a long term. That's why you see everyone, including us, preaching about long term investments in equities and doing a consistent investments in equity to ensure that you get the returns. Why do people don't make return? We get to hear this from everyone. Because we either invest too aggressively or we don't invest. That's one. Second, if we invest into sectoral calls. We take infrastructure. Everyone pushes me, are you not investing in equity? And then I am just pushing myself, rushing myself into investing into equity. There is no structured way of putting money. Huh? Mm-hmm. If I follow a simple, consistent approach of investing with a long-term view for the asset which I know I'll not be touching for the next 10 years or likewise period, there is no reason why you will not make inflation-adjusted money. You have to make money. The same rationale, if you use for real estate, why do people make money over there? Simply because I've held it for 10, 15 years. Why can't I use the same logic over here? Because maybe this is more transparent. The transparency itself is a folly over here, which I'm surprised is not there in real estate. So maybe that's helping real estate as a market. Mm. Maybe that's helped my insurance business because of this, because of lack of transparency. And because I'm offering the transparency over here, I can see my value on a daily basis. So you do get calls. If our market goes up by 20%, let's book profits. But then what? I book my profits today, then where do I go tomorrow? What happens for the next? So my planning goes for a toss. If I look at a long-term horizon, you are bound to make money. So please stick to your basic plans, stick to your allocation right, look at diversifying your portfolio, and you will make money.
Suresh, your thoughts?
I'm just going to add something from the financial planning perspective. See, for achieving certain goals, short-term, medium-term, long-term, we require a certain amount of portfolio return. So we do not really look at equity return or a debt return or a return from property and things like that. See, the point is now we are ultimately looking at a portfolio that we have created for a particular purpose. Now, like Surya had mentioned, equities are low-risk products over a long period of time. In the short term, there can be volatility, and short term equities can deliver very poor returns to very good returns. So we really cannot rely on equity in the short term. But the problem with the typical retail investor is that they get very gung-ho about equities, and that is the role I think of that we as financial planners play. We have to ensure that the asset allocation in the portfolio is properly done, so that over a period of time, whatever requirements they have as far as money is concerned to meet short-term, medium-term, long-term goals do come to them. So that is, we have to explain to our client the concept of risk-adjusted return, and equity as an asset class can give potentially double-digit risk-adjusted return over a long period of time. And that is what we tend to tell our client, that you need to definitely invest in equity if you want to achieve certain goals. Otherwise, you better be earning extremely, extremely well so that you can invest all the money in fixed income instruments. But yeah, that is a hypothetical situation, and that really does not hold good for most of the people. So investing in equity is absolutely necessary. That does not mean we have to just throw the money into any equity instrument that comes up. For retail investors, equity mutual funds is an instrument of choice, because there is a fund manager who is actually managing the risk for you, who is doing the investment for you, whose only job along with his team is to actually take care of the corpus and give an intended target return. There is no target per se, but yeah, you can talk about a double digit return over a long period of time. So we tend to invest investors' money in mutual funds, and ETF also is another excellent avenue for investing people's money because of the low cost associated with ETFs.
Okay, Lovaii, your final thoughts on this?
Yeah, so I think if we were to look at equity investments over long periods of time, traditionally, you will find that the returns have been good. They are essentially equal to the GDP growth of the country plus the expected rate of inflation. So that's the bare minimum sort of return that you could expect in equity. So in today's scenario, probably 12% per annum. If GDP goes up, maybe 14-15% per annum is what your expectation should be. Now, if you are in a country where the GDP is growing and the economy is positive, that means that the trend is upward. And the worry always is that am I sort of entering at the top, and will I lose money over a long period of time? So the important thing then to do is to ensure that you cut the risk of investing in equity, which is by staggering your investment. When I say staggering your investment, I do not mean only SIP, because there are many people who may find that they need to be putting half their money in equity, but they are today at maybe 10%. So I'm not saying that you do it in an SIP manner. It may take you a few years before you get to a 50% allocation. But you should look at a 12-15 month time horizon by which you say some part I will do through an SIP or a systematic transfer plan route, and some part I will use opportunities whenever I see certain falls. So I hear some event. Because of that event, over a 4-day, 5-day, 1-week period, the market falls by 3-4%. I take some part of my money, I put it in. So I think it's very important to do that in a disciplined manner. Which brings me to the point that the maximum cause for returns in equity, in my mind, is discipline. It's not picking the right stock, it's not picking the best fund, it's not choosing the best time, but just having the discipline of running through whatever your asset allocation tells you and what your intended target is. So I think that's very important. To the point that Surya made about real estate, I think I agree with him that, you know, just being transparent and being open about equity and looking at the fact that I can exit equity at any point in time, whereas exiting real estate is really very painful, is sort of making people get in and get out of equity. So maybe, you know, if you're looking at mutual funds, for example, if the exit loads in mutual funds were increased for equities, then people would by habit say, I'd much rather not pay that 1% exit load or 2% exit load, I'll stay invested for 3 years. And that maybe will allow a shifting of habit. I think the other thing is that, you know, 1 year investment in equity is long term, and there's a lower tax rate or a zero tax rate. Maybe that should also go up to a longer period of time. You'll actually have more money in equities, is what I think. And I think it's absolutely essential when you compare it with other asset classes over a 5-year, 10-year period, that you will find that equity does come out tops, especially in economies and countries where the growth is upward. And I don't think anyone has an iota of doubt at this moment with India, with the demographics, with the consumption, with the change in leadership at the top, to make sure that, you know, it will result in greater return for clients.
All right, gentlemen, we ended there. Thank you very much, all three of you, for joining me on this very auspicious day. I once again wish you all a very happy Diwali, and thank you very much. Truly appreciate you coming by and sharing your thoughts with our viewers out here on Smart Money. All right, with that, it's a wrap on this special edition of Smart Money. Once again, I wish you a very happy and prosperous Diwali. Always remember, wealth cannot be earned, it can only be created. And we at Smart Money will continue to help you to grow and protect your money. We will be back same time next week with many more strategies for your finances. Keep watching.
To get expert opinions on your finances, you can send us your queries at smartmoney@btvin.com. You can also call us on 022-4098-7098. You can also send us an SMS. Just type SM, give a space, write your query and send it to 877-327-0010.